Well, let me tell you about this fourth man. Who is this fourth man? I'll tell you who he is. In Genesis, he's the seed of woman. In Exodus, he's the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, he's our high priest. In Numbers, he's our pillar of cloud by day and pillar of fire by night. In Deuteronomy, he's the prophet likened to Moses. In Joshua, he's the captain of our salvation. In Joshua, he's the captain of our salvation. In Judges, he's our judge and lawgiver. In Ruth, he's our kinsman and redeemer. In 1 and 2 Samuel, he's our trusted prophet. In 1 and 2 Kings and Chronicles, he's our reigning king. In Ezra, he's our faithful scribe. In Nehemiah, he's the rebuilder of the broken down walls of human life. In Esther, he's our Mordecai. In Job, he's our ever-living Redeemer. For Job said, I know my Redeemer liveth. Hallelujah. Who is this fourth man? I'll tell you who he is. In Psalms, he's our shepherd. In Proverbs and Ecclesiastes, he's our wisdom. In the Song of Solomon, he's our lover and bridegroom. In Isaiah, he's the Prince of Peace. In Jeremiah, he's the righteous branch. In Lamentations, he's the weeping prophet. In Ezekiel, he's the wonderful four-faced man. In Daniel, he's the fourth man in the fiery furnaces of life. Who is this fourth man? I'll tell you who he is. In Hosea, he's the faithful husband. In Joel, he's the baptizer with the Holy Ghost. In Amos, he's our burden bearer. In Obadiah, he's the mighty to save. In Jonah, he's our foreign missionary. In Micah, he's the messenger with beautiful feet. In Nahum, he's the avenger of God's elect. In Habakkuk, he's God's evangelist. In Zephaniah, he's our savior. In Haggai, he's the restorer of God's lost heritage. In Zechariah, he's the fountain open in the house of David. In Malachi, he's the son of righteousness with healing in his wings. Hallelujah! Who is this fourth man? I'll tell you who he is. In Matthew, he's the Messiah. In Mark, he's the wonder worker. In Luke, he's the Son of Man. In John, he's the Son of God. In Acts, he's the Holy Ghost. In Romans, he's the justifier. In 1 and 2 Corinthians, he's the sanctifier. In Galatians, he's the redeemer from the curse of the law. In Ephesians, he's the Christ with unsearchable riches. In Philippians, he's the God that supplies all our needs. In Colossians, he's the fullness of the Godhead bodily. In 1 and 2 Thessalonians, he's our soon coming King. Hallelujah. Who is this fourth man? Who is this fourth man? I'll tell you who he is. In 1 and 2 Timothy, he's the mediator between God and man. In Titus, he's our faithful pastor. In Philemon, he's the friend that sticketh closer than a brother. Who is this fourth man? I'll tell you who he is. In Hebrews, he's the blood of the everlasting covenant. In James, he's our great physician. In 1 and 2 Peter, he's the chief shepherd. In 1st, 2nd, 3rd John, he is love. In Jude, he's the Lord coming with 10,000 angels. Hallelujah. Who is this fourth man? I'll tell you who he is. In the book of Revelations, he's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Who is this man that showed up in the fiery furnace? Who is this man that'll show up in every fiery furnace where you refuse to compromise? I'll tell you who he is. He's Abel's sacrifice. He's Noah's rainbow. He's Abraham's ram. He's Isaac's well. He's Jacob's scepter. He's Moses' rod. He's Joshua's sun and moon that stood still. He's Elijah's mantle. He's Elijah's staff. He's Gideon's fleece. He's Samuel's horn of oil. He's David's slingshot. He's Isaiah's fig poultice. He's Hezekiah's sundial. He's Daniel's visions. He's Amos' burden. And Malachi, he's the son of righteousness. Who is this fourth man? I'll tell you who he is. He's Peter's shadow. He's Stephen's signs and wonders. He's Paul's handkerchiefs. He's John's pearly white city. Hallelujah. Who is this fourth man? Who is this fourth man that'll enter the fiery furnace when you dare to stand uncompromisingly? He's the father to the orphan. He's the husband to the widow. He's the traveler in the night that is traveling. He is the bright and morning star to those that are in the lonesome valley. He's the lily of the valley. He's the rose of Sharon. He's the honey in the rock. He's the brightness of God's glory. He's the express image of the person of God. He's the King of glory, the pearl of great price, the rock in a weary land, the cup that runneth over, the rod and the staff that comfort. He's the government of the lion, and our lives are upon his shoulder. Who is this fourth man? He's Jesus of Nazareth, the Son of